Welcome to our program on the Laguna Woods Film Club. My name is Susan Hecht. Some of you may already know me because I also teach through the Saddleback College Emeritus Institute. Others of you have seen me at the Film Club when we held our monthly showings at the large auditorium in Clubhouse 3. Since we can't meet right now, this is one way that we can stay in touch. I want to tell you today a little bit about the film club, and then also to tell you about two films that we have shown in the past that I have really loved and that you can see now on Amazon Prime. First of all, I want to tell you about our mission statement. Our purpose for the film club is, it is a film series to bring art and or classic foreign and independent films to Laguna Woods Village. Each monthly film is introduced and followed by a discussion by an expert on film, and that's me. We also have a film club board who choose all the films, and they handle our registration and our marketing. And our membership is filled out with people like you who love films. Do you know that the film club has been meeting for 34 and a half years? It was started as a place where members could share quality movies and then talk about them afterwards. 34 years ago, we didn't have the options we have now, but we have found that we still love to see movies together on a big screen and then talk about them. We have a certain kind of movie that we like to show. We show quality films where the characters grapple with moral and societal issues. We like to show indie or foreign films, films that sometimes were made without a large budget, but with a big heart. Films that give us insights into different cultures. We hold the vision that we will once again be able to come together once a month to see and talk about great films. And in that vein, I would like to, as I said, I would now like to introduce two of our favorite films that we previously have shown. I chose to talk about these two films because they both illustrate the theme of people coming together. And during this time of the COVID disease and social distancing, many of us are longing for connection. It is so heartening to watch films where the characters can act this out. Last year, in our 2019 and 2020 season, which we didn't get a chance to finish, we showed this beautiful Japanese film that was just, I think, well, let me show you. It revolved around a Japanese snack called a dorayaki, and it looks like this. Well, this is my version of it anyway. It's two pancakes, and in between, you have a wonderful red bean paste. Only, I'm not much of a cook, so I put the American version and put strawberry jam. But you get the idea. In the film Sweet Bean, which was filmed in 2015, we have three lonely characters. We have a very moody young man who works the dorayaki stall. His name is Sentaro. And as he's making these wonderful pancake sandwiches, there's a lonely high school girl, Wakana, who is, she just loves dorayakis, and she sits there after school. Her mom's a single mom, doesn't pay much attention to her. Into these two characters' lives comes a very mysterious older woman, Tokyo. And she eats the dorayaki and she likes it. However, she tells Sentaro that his red bean paste is good, but she knows a way to make it better. Ah, I warn you, you may be hungry after watching this. There's a lot of wonderful films of them making the dorayakis from scratch. So the questions here are, can these three unique souls be friends? And can they change their lives for the better? One critic said, this film is a meditation on attentiveness, perseverance, and humble courage. The story takes place over a year. In the background, we have the cycle of the seasons with beautiful photography illustrating the earth's changes. In the poster, you will see a large cherry blossom tree, and that is one of the symbols in the film. I think this film is a sweet taste of life. We'll now show you the trailer for our Japanese movie, Sweet Bean.
いらっしゃい。こういう仕事を一度してみたかったの。力仕事なんですよ。ずっと作ってきたのよ。もう50年も。これちょっと食べてみて。何ですか？なんだこれ。
ざるに開けて、あずき、ざるに開けて、触りに開けて、ちょっと硬い。ちょっと硬い。持ち上げて。はい、よしよし。頑張んなさいよ。はい。あずきに行ったの。はあ。よし。よしよしよしよし。こんなの初めてです。美味しいよね。
Our second film is really different. It's filmed in New Zealand. We showed it during the 2018 and 2019 season. It's called Hunt for the Wilder People. If you've never heard of the term wilder people before, none of us have. And I'm not going to tell you what it means. You have to watch the movie. This film, done in 2016, introduced many of us to the writer and director, let me see if I can say his name right, Taika Waititi. And he, last year, he won the Oscar for his 2020 screenplay, Jojo Rabbit. For those of you who saw Jojo Rabbit and you know the quirkiness of that film, this was an earlier film which has that same unusual sort of just sense of humor. At the very beginning of the film, we meet Ricky, and he's a rebellious New Zealand urban teenager, and he's got an attitude. He's been in and out of the New Zealand foster care system. He's an orphan. And this is his last chance to find a home. He's placed with a really unique couple who live out in the boondocks, Bella and Hector. Now, Ricky figures, you know, he has this situation handled, but quickly we understand that he has met his match. One of the critics said this is a quirky but good-natured film growing up. But it's not only Ricky who has some maturing to do. On the poster, you'll see the wonderful New Zealand actor Sam Neill, who plays his stepdad Hector. In the film, the director, Taiki Waititi, also makes a cameo as a preacher. He's very, very funny. It's shot on location in the stunning New Zealand countryside. And I think that you'll really enjoy going on the hunt for the wilder people. We're now going to show you the trailer for our 2016 New Zealand movie, Hunt for the Wilder People.
Ricky Baker.
He is a bad egg, a youth court regular.
We're hoping that this change of scene will help straighten him out.
You hungry? That's a silly question, isn't it? Look at you.
Ricky Baker, now you are 13 years old. You are a teenager and you're as good as gold.
Ricky, this is Heck. You can call him uncle if you like.
No, I can't.
Bella told me to tell you that you should give me something to do. Is there anything you want me to do?
Yeah. Leave me alone.
Cool. You ever been up in that jungle before?
There's about a million hectares of it, buddy. It's easy to get lost.
You lost? I'm amazed how lost you got.
You little bastard!
We got no choice but to camp out here for a few weeks.
Where are you, Ricky Baker?
More on this massive national manhunt.
Faulkner is Caucasian. Well, they got that wrong because you're obviously white.
You're going to jail, you pervert.
What'd you call me?
A pervert.
Back up, homies, and let go of my uncle! So what do we do now?
We run. No, we don't need to run.
Huh? Oh, yeah, this is fast walk.
Gonna be rough. No huts, no tents, real bush life. And if you play up, I dump you.
Okay, Uncle.
I'd still prefer if you don't call me Uncle.
Sounds pretty good, doesn't it?
What's the fastest way out of here?
Jetpack!
Do you actually have a jetpack?
No? What?
We're offering $10,000 to anyone who can capture them, dead or alive. Alive. They should be alive.
Crumpy!
She's a bit bumpy around here.
Love you, Ricky.
Ricky!
Ricky! Ah! Isn't that Alex who did this? Tell them it was the Wilder People.
The Water People?
Stop running.
Yeah, and I'll never stop chasing you. I'm relentless. I'm like the Terminator.
I'm more like Terminator than you.
I said it first. You're more like Sarah Connor. And in the first movie, too, before she could do chin-ups.
Before we finish for today, I have one other film that I would like to talk about. Our film club board is fabulous. They do so much work. They already have a list of films ready for when we hope we're going to be back in Clubhouse 3 showing our monthly films. So I just wanted to tell you about one of the films that they have in mind for you to see. I chose this film because the main character is really strong in the face of great odds. And I think this is a time in our lives when we are really wanting to hear about people who can indeed be courageous. This film was shot in 2013. It's an English film called Belle. It was inspired by a true story. Belle was an amazing woman. She was the mixed race, illegitimate daughter of Royal Navy Captain Sir John Lindsay. She is well loved, and her whole name is Dido Elizabeth Bell. Her father can't take character. He's in the Royal Navy, he's going here and there. And she is placed in her great uncle's house. He is a wealthy 18th century Captain Lindsay, who is also known as Lord William Murray. I see if I can get all of these names. You know, the English royalty, they have all of these names and titles. Okay, so excuse me, let me start again. So Captain Lindsay places Bell with his great uncle, Lord William Murray, the first Earl of Mansfield, and his wife. So one of the interesting things here, and it's very fortuitous, is that the Earl, who becomes Bell's father, has a political position of Lord Chief Justice. And he has decisions to make on the issues of slavery. Bell, although she's grown up in this wealthy English home, she's of mixed race. And she has encountered a lot of prejudice. So she wants to make a difference in her country. Can she influence Lord Murray when he has decisions to make on slavery? I wanted to tell you about this film also because of the race issues that we still face in this country and around the world. And even though this movie is based on a real woman of the 18th century, I think that you'll find that we still can relate to the issues going on. I hope we can watch this film next year together. If you see the poster of this film, you will see the beautiful actress who's playing Belle. She is also mixed race. Her name, I'm not sure exactly how to pronounce it. I think it's Guju Mbatha-Ra. She's English. She was raised by a South African father and an English mother. And I think she's just perfect as Belle. And our last trailer for today will be for our English film, Belle.
Do not be afraid. I am here to take you to a good life, a life that you were born to. I beg you, Uncle, love her as I would were I here, and ensure that she is in receipt of all that is due to her as a child of mine.
Do you have in mind my position?
That is simply impossible.
What is right can never be impossible.
What has she been named?
Dido Bell Lindsay.
She takes your name.
I am not ashamed.
We will call her Dido.
Elizabeth was in much need of a companion.
And that is what we shall say when questions are asked.
We shall be receiving visitors for dinner.
Why do you not dine with your family ever?
Because that is not correct.
May I present the second of my two nieces, Miss Dido Lindsay?
I find her repulsive.
Papa, how may I be too high in rank to dine with the servants and too low to dine with my family?
Though I understand she is kept under interesting rules, she raises questions.
Would you do me the honor of taking some air with me?
Don't you care what people will say?
What should anyone say?
I had no idea she would be so black.
One does not make a wife of the rare and exotic.
Does she still have a tongue?
I have a tongue.
Though yours explains well enough why I may not marry your son. My greatest misfortune would be to marry into a family who would carry me as their shame.
I've enabled every rule of convention so that you would know exactly where you belong.
I don't know that I find myself anywhere. Do you love her?
As though she were created of you and me.
What of your mother?
I know very little of her other than the color she has given me.
Then at least you know she was beautiful.
You would risk your position for a man without name.
Laws that allow us to diminish the humanity of anybody are not laws.
He speaks a voice for people who do not have one.
If I had your choice, I would choose the man I loved.
There are rules in place which dictate how we live.
You break every rule when it matters enough, Papa. I am the evidence.
this ends our program for today. I'm wishing you many happy movie hours, and I look forward to welcoming you to the film club in the future. Take care. Bye-bye.